Six bodies have been recovered after the fire inside the hydroelectric plant in Telangana. 12 hours and counting to that fire, and three still said to be trapped inside. We have Uma Sudhir for the latest. Uma?
Yes, indeed, Sunal. Very, very tragic developments that have happened, unfolded since 10:30 yesterday night when this fire actually broke out at the Srisailam Hydel power project in the left bank in Telangana region. And this happened in what is called as a tunnel project. And that's where the fire broke out at 10:30, after which there are 20 people working inside. 11 managed to come out, but 9 people were still trapped inside. And subsequently, the rescue teams, they tried to send them in, but it was very, very challenging. We had smoke and fire coming out, and it was very difficult for the rescue teams. They tried 4 to 5 times with all kinds of equipment to try and go inside, but with all that smoke, it was proving to be very difficult. But subsequently, just a short while ago, on the third floor, they managed to, in fact, unfortunately, six of those 9 people who were trapped. This includes, we are told, assistant engineers and others. All of them have been identified, but the search is
all right. We have some audio trouble there with Uma's line. We'll just try and reconnect. But if you're just joining us, let me just recap for you what is the information we have at this point. Now, since morning, we had known that a fire broke out at a factory. In fact, at a plant called the Srisailam Hydroelectricity Plant in Telangana. At 10:30 last night, the fire was first reported. Early this morning, we knew of at least 9 people still being trapped. Out of those 9, we are now told that 6 bodies have actually now been recovered from that fire. 3 still trapped inside. It all started, we are told, at the moment with a short circuit that was reported close to the dam area on the left bank. Uma Sudhir back with us. Uma, you were telling us about who these people are whose lives have so tragically been lost.
This includes a divisional engineer who has been identified as Mr. Srinivas. And we are talking about 4 other assistant engineers as well. There were 2 more junior plant assistants who were also missing, and 2 other employees of Amar Raja batteries who were trapped inside. 9 in all. It was more than 14 hours, in fact, from 10:30 last night. You can count the number of hours, and it's taken that long for these rescue teams, which included not just the rescue team of the Hydel Power Project itself and the local police, but also people who were brought in from Singareni collieries who have some experience of going into these kind of underground kind of units and rescuing people trapped inside. You also had the NDRF, the National Disaster Response Force teams, being brought in, and we are also told the Central Industrial Security team, CISF teams, were also brought in, and they were equipped with the masks and the oxygen cylinders necessary to, in order to be able to go inside the tunnel where there was very, very heavy smoke. Of course, because of the current being cut off, even otherwise, we were told that last night, in fact, when the fire happened initially itself in the 4th unit, that's when they had tried to trip the reactors, the power units there, but at that time, it did not happen, and then they had to isolate that particular unit, and subsequently, they managed to trip all the units, and that's when the operation really began of trying to get in the rescue teams and making them go inside the Hydel Power Project site itself in order to be able to rescue. For so many hours, the rescue teams have tried very hard. They were finding it very difficult to go into the different floors. They were able to reach only till the 3rd floor, and some of them tried to manage to go to the 3rd, 4th, and 5th floor as well. And that's where they found these bodies of these 6 people. 3 more people still inside. And the rescue team and the authorities really hoping against hope that in some way they could be found alive. Of course, with the kind of gas and the kind of heat that was there inside, it was very, very challenging even for the rescue teams to try and reach those who they knew were trapped inside this Hydel plant itself. The CMD as of now saying that the cause of such an accident not known. It is quite unprecedented. It happened inside the power plant and one of the units there at a time when all these all these projects. In fact, the reservoirs that are attached to them are all flooding, and Srisilam, all the spillway gates were in fact opened yesterday. 10 spillway gates were opened yesterday because of the huge amount of waters that are there in those reservoirs. And Nagarjuna Sagar also opened just a short while ago, a couple of hours ago, in order to let the waters go. But at this time, an accident happening, which is being seen as quite unprecedented. As of now, they say a short circuit may have led to the fire, but detailed investigation will have to follow to know what went so wrong inside the Heidel power plant. Back to you.
Right, Uma Sudhir, they're taking you through the latest. We know at this hour a really tragic incident there where at least six people at this point have lost their lives, three more said to be trapped. And this has been a fire which has been running for the past 14 hours or so. 10 people have been rescued, but at the moment, things looking tough for those still trapped inside.